Welcome to DB Vlogs. I'm just in the city centre here now. I started the vlog off very late. I was late for an appointment. But I just want to show you guys how beautiful this city, this Dublin city centre is. Take a look. There you go. There's still a bit more to show you, but it's a beautiful city. I am so happy that I do live in Dublin, because it's beautiful. It's absolutely beautiful, especially on nice weather. But I'm wearing a big bubble jacket because I got up early this morning to go to my doctor's appointment. So that's why I missed my vlog this morning, because I was late getting up, struggling to get out of that bed. We'll be right back. thinking of coming to a holiday, Dublin. Dublin's the place to be. It's a beautiful city. It's on a nice day, it's absolutely packed. Packed to the brim. Yeah, thanks for watching the vlogs, guys. I'm still not home yet because we all had to get off the Lewis because of some drunken fool got sick all over the Lewis, and we all had to get off. He was messing. It was absolutely stinking, and the smell of it was horrible. So now we're here waiting for another Lewis to bring me home, and I can't wait to go home to get changed and into shorts and a t-shirt and get out of this big jacket. I didn't think it was going to be so warm this morning. I really didn't. Well, I got up and I got out of the house at 7:30 this morning and put this jacket on me, and I'm regretting it now. But I'll see you in the Lewis. Cheers, guys. I made it home finally. Took ages because we had to change Lewis. But yesterday I mentioned in one of my vlogs that today's vlog is going to be about me, who I am and what I'm about. My name is Darren Bradley. I'm from Dublin, Ireland. I'm born and reared here. I have a brother and two sisters. I don't see them. I don't see my brother. I don't see my sisters. I don't see any of my family whatsoever. It's only me in this world, really. My brother is a heroin user. He's homeless. I tried to take him in, but he keeps taking my money and taking my stuff and selling it for his drugs. So I can't let him into the house no more. My two sisters have kids. They're living down in Ballyferm with their boyfriends and kids. So when I was younger, when I was about 3, I was taken away from my parents and put into a foster home because my mum and dad were alcoholics. They loved their drink more than they loved their kids. One day it was me, my brother and my two sisters in the house, and I was 3, and the house caught fire and my parents weren't there. They were out drinking with their friends in the pub,
while me, my brother and my two sisters were in this house while it was on fire. Our neighbour came in and took us out and they helped us. They called the guards, the ambulance, and everybody was out. And then we were taken away from my mum and dad. We were put into childcare. Me and my brother were put into a foster home while my two sisters were put into my nanny's house in Ballyferma. So we were separated from early age and we never really stayed in contact. Me and my brother were forced off to a foster home in Rathmines, where we stayed for 16, 17 years. It was nice, it was good living there, it was, but I was just a bold little boy. Getting in trouble in school, getting in trouble with the police, giving them a hard time. They didn't have to take us in, but they seen us in the children's home. They liked the look of us and they picked us. It's mad, like, because we were in the children's home for about 2 months, and about 20 different couples came to view you, to see if they want to bring you home or not. Or, you know, it's mad. It's like a pick and mix. If they don't like you, they won't bring you home. They don't like the look of you, they won't bring you home. That's what most kids in my situation are facing nowadays. It's kind of sad when you think about it, that people are just coming up and picking you out because they like the look of you, or they like your story, or it's crazy. But I have two kids now myself, and I'm all grown up now. I have to say, kids have changed my life completely. Because when I was 16, 17, 18, and going into my 20s, I was just so bold. Now I'm 30 now. But, yeah, my mum died when I was 9, and my father died when I was 18. My mum died from alcohol poisonous, and my dad died of bad health and being homeless and suffering from drink and stuff like that. So my parents are dead now, so I only really have my brother and my two sisters, but I don't really see them. So, but it's hard, you know, not having parents there to fall back on or to talk to or talk about your day. You know, it's everybody needs a parent. Everybody needs parents, you know. I put my past behind me. I'm sorry if I'm just rambling on and on and off, as I just don't know what to be saying. This vlog is going to be, I just hope it just sparks off so people can see the struggles that people go through in their life, and not judge a book by its cover. Nobody should just judge a book by its cover. Thanks for watching, and I hope you like the video. And if you do like the video, subscribe for more and share it around. Cheers, guys.